Hello everybody, welcome back to the ePanacea business, the Panacea eBiz platform and resolve the unsolved remains a theme. Over the last couple of weeks, we have tried to cover various aspects of business propositions, be it manpower, be it to do with business valuation, understanding different business perspective, and we have got valued feedbacks from our participants and the entrepreneurs and from our expert panels also. Today, we are going to focus on a very, very important aspect of any business deal making, whether it is small, big, whether it is selling a product or any kind of collaborations. I'm sure all of you are aware and agree that negotiation plays a very, very instrumental and a very, very important role to finalize any deal. And most of the time we have seen or we have observed while working or associating with various organizations and corporates, people sometimes tend to walk into a negotiation without a proper planning, not realizing that you need to plan and approach a negotiation structure or a decision making in a very professional manner. Obviously, I will leave it to our expert today to take it on and share it with you. With that, let me introduce you to my other co-panelists, Mr. Ravinder Goyal and Mr. Iqbal Singh Rana. Mr. Goyal, some of you are already familiar with him, the founder of Panacea eBiz Group. He himself is a veteran in vocational skilling with 27 years of experience. He's a technology entrepreneur and have delivered constant successes in the IT training and services. And because of his contribution in education and training, he was awarded the Gem of India Award in 2002 and also won the role of honor in the Skills Champion Emerging Warrior Adjust by Fiki Skills. Today, he is driving three major tech initiatives, which you will be coming to know as we go forward. Today, our guest speaker is Mr. Iqbal Singh Rana. Mr. Rana, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Mr. Rana is the Managing Director of Corporate Productive Consultancy. He has a rich experience of 30 plus years in consulting and advising corporates across the sector. He has consulted and trained senior and mid-level managers, as I mentioned, across the sector from banking to insurance into FMCG, automotive, consumer durables, manufacturing, pharma, etc. Mr. Rana brings with him a wealth of knowledge, and in fact, in the areas of negotiation, he has spent considerable time in guiding and mentoring corporates in planning for decision making, as well as a final stage negotiations too. To start off with, I request Mr. Goyal to say a few words. Mr. Goyal, please.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Sandeep. Hello, entrepreneurs. Welcome you all in our 8th webinar on behalf of Panacea eBiz Consulting Group's forum, Resolve the Unsolved. Our today's topic is negotiation strategies for success. What I believe most of the people carry a conflicting understanding between negotiation and arguments. Argument is all about winning, and negotiation is mostly about achieving the win-win situation wherein both the parties or all the parties agrees to a situation which is acceptable to all. Foremost thing requires to negotiate is a clear understanding of your requirements, what all can be negotiated, and what is minimum that you want, and same for the other party with whom you are in negotiation. When you start negotiating with your perspective in mind only, the negotiation becomes a battle and winning becomes necessary. Attitude is everything in a negotiation. It's important to go in with an open mind and be prepared to improvise. Opportunities will pop up, so will obstacles. We have to make the best whatever unfolds. Mostly people believe that holding your cards close to the vest or not giving away your agenda is a vice in negotiation. But on the contrary, I believe stating what you want can improve the opportunity for both the sides. As I said earlier, one should also determine the fallback or bare minimum one will accept. You may go in asking for the moon, but be sure you know when to walk away. Hold on your anxiety and practice to remain calm. Your body language plays a significant role too. Stand with your head slightly tilted and your hand with a smile and a gaze that meets the other person's eye. The head tilt exposes the neck and says, I am listening, I am comfortable, I am receptive. Let me share the Japanese way of negotiating. Japanese do believe to follow a basic principle, that is, face must not be lost and politeness must be maintained at all times. The Japanese go to the incredible length to be polite. Their reluctance to say no is well known. If the Japanese do not wish to enter into a deal with the partner, they will not come out with a negative reply. However, you will not be able to get in touch with your contact in that company thereafter. If you are not aligned with the way negotiation is going on, you may take a small break. If you can't physically leave the room, at least take deep breaths. Give a pause before you open up your part of response. It gives you time to absorb, digest, and carefully consider your response, but also might create discomfort on the part, which could lead to a better deal.
Sure.
Today we have Mr. Iqbal Singh Rana with us, who is a behavior coach, sales trainer, and FMCG expert. He'll be sharing much more about negotiating strategies for success. I request all of you to put forward your queries in chat box, along with your name and mobile number. After the session is over, we will try to answer as many queries as possible. I thank you all for listening to me. Request Sandeep to take this further now. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Goyal.
Thank you, Mr. Goyal.
Rana sir, it's over to you.
Thank you, Sandeep. Thank you, Goyalji. Pleasure being with you people. And by the way, the way I see that number of people coming in is increasing, and I find some very senior people around. There's Mr. Dr. K.K. Upadhyay, who has been at a very senior level in FICCI. And maybe he's now retired from there, is a very senior consultant. There's Mr. Gajinder Bains there, there's Shiri Daman there. I also find one or two people from Nepal there, because I'd sent an invitation to them also. So welcome everyone. And it will be a pleasure to interact with you. Ideally, in negotiation, generally, we do a session which is a 3-day or 4-day long session. So we have a challenge here to compress it to about half an hour. So I was looking at what are the most critical things which I will like to cover. That is one. Second thing is, what I have generally seen is that many of us are not able to catch our own mistakes. And thereby, whenever someone is suggesting something or giving up, or giving a gyan on something, generally, mujhe aisa lagta hai ki mere ko apply nahi karta hai, mujhe sab pata. But friends, I feel the people who really become better are the people who are able to introspect, who are able to see, oh my God, what he is saying, does it apply to me? And if it applies to me, what should I do about it? That is the success. Because otherwise, sab cheeze badi generic hai, sab cheeze aaj internet pe available hai. You keep on hearing so many things. And there are so many angles to it. Negotiation itself has 4 or 5 different angles to it. And by the way, one of the angles is, what are the dirty tricks in negotiation and how do you handle those? Which we are not going to cover today. Maybe some other day we'll cover. There's an aspect of what all to do before you enter into negotiation. There's an aspect of that. And there's an aspect of whatever you speak, can it be categorized into various categories, and which are the desirable categories, which are the undesirable categories. So there are various aspects to negotiation. I am going to just touch on some of those and answer some questions. And maybe you will like to apply it to yourself and say, oh my God, is it that I am also doing this mistake? Maybe next time I need to be careful. I think that is what you can take away from the seminar. And maybe later on, if there's some opportunity, we will go deeper into it by doing a longer session. I will now upload my PPT, which I'll use along in a very short, small way. I'm not going to dominate my discussion through PPT, but as a supporting material, I'll use it. So can I have be a co-host, Goyalji?
Yeah, I'm just making you a host. Co-host, yeah. It is not visible.
Okay.
So I'm just making you host.
Right. So I'll essentially take up three key concepts today and just share those key concepts with you in a very brief way. And you will have some questions. Maybe you will write in chat box. Sandeep will help me later on to assimilate all those questions and put it forward, because I may not be able to go to chat box while I'm conversing with people.
Sure.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. So, negotiations for success. I hope my slide has already come through.
Right.
Yeah.
It's there.
So I'll quickly go about. I'll not spend so much of time to make introductory remarks. I will share with you this one very critical thing, and I feel it has an important implication. What is this difference and the relationship between selling and negotiation? There is a link. So what is this link? Then five principles of negotiation. These five key principles, if you keep in mind and evaluate yourself, and maybe so many times you are not able to evaluate yourself, maybe you are going along with one of your colleagues to negotiation. If two of you are going, that's a great opportunity. Because then you can observe each other as to what are you doing on negotiation. And now that you will have certain nuggets with you, you will be able to tick or cross or give scores on each of these to the other person who is your colleague. Yeah, tumne ye to kiya, ye nahi kiya. Ye kam kiya, ye jyada kiya. Because you yourself cannot score your own negotiation while you are doing it. And the third is, I will also share with you, what does it mean by BATNA? What does it mean by SOFA? What does it mean by VAP? And what is the application of this negotiation? So I am going to concentrate on that. Sandeep, I hope I have time till about 3:40.
Yes, please.
So around 3:40, 3:45, I will wrap up so that there's some time to discuss and answer questions.
Perfectly fine.
So friends, now the first one quickly. Selling and negotiation mein farak kya hai? That is what we are going to do first. Rather than asking for various views, which takes away about 5-7 minutes, let me straight away come to it. Selling is when the customer says, I would like to do business with you. If the customer is not ready to do business with you, then there's no point of negotiating. And I've found some excellent brokers who are property dealers, no? They're doing this. जब आपने उसको बोला मुझे कुछ घर दिखाइए, घर खरीदने हैं, तो जब उसने आपने घर वगैरह देख लिए, and he is putting you in front of the seller, and the seller को आपने बताया कि आप इसका 50 लाख रुपए मांग रहे हैं, बहुत ज्यादा मांग रहे हैं, प्लीज क्या कुछ हो सकता है, and a smart seller says to you कि वैसे आपने मन बना लिया है क्या इस पे, आपने यही खरीदना है क्या, क्या कोई और भी आपके साथ इन्वॉल्व है क्या, कहता हाँ मेरे फादर भी इन्वॉल्व है मेरे साथ, कहता वो भी डिसीजन रखता हम भी लेते हैं, कहता कोई बुरा मत मानिए, आप उनसे पहले डिस्कस कर लीजिए, कल या परसों का दोबारा टाइम कर लेते हैं, व्हेन ही विल आल्सो बी देयर दैट टाइम वी विल लुक एट कितना कम हो सकता है. आई एम श्योर यू वुड हैव सीन दैट. सो सेलिंग इज व्हेन द कस्टमर सेज यस आई वॉन्ट टू बाई दिस प्रॉपर्टी, यस आई वॉन्ट टू डू बिजनेस विद यू, यस आई एम लाइकिंग योर प्रोपोजिशन. When the other person says that, then only negotiation comes. Otherwise, don't enter into negotiation. And negotiation is essentially agreeing on the terms and conditions on which you can do business. I hope this difference is clear. That is how we are at least defining it. Yeah. And now keeping this in mind, I have a question for all of you. Everyone just look at this next slide. And then please tell me that how will you rank these from easy to difficult to negotiate? These are the three situations. Tell me which is the easiest, which one is little difficult, which is more difficult. Dr. Upadhyay is very, very involved in all these things. So he knows these things very well. But even then, maybe he'll give opportunity to some other people first. Yes, sir. Someone would like to say? You can put on your audio and then say it. Which one is the easiest? Which one is little difficult? Which is the most difficult?
I think I would like to go with this. I'm Amresh.
Yeah, please. Please, Amresh, welcome from Nepal.
Welcome, sir. Thank you, sir. I think the most difficult one is A, because like sir said, selling comes before negotiation. So whatever A is selling to me is selling to client, they have a difference. They have no agreeing. So I think A is the most difficult. I think C is a part where they are trying to understand, and both the party understand that it is required. So it is in the middle way. I think B is the most easiest.
Absolutely. Absolutely. I hope everyone got it. There is a lot of agreement between me and the client in the B part. They are overlapping. Whereas in A, nothing is overlapping. If nothing is overlapping, which means the client is not keen to do business with you. And I'm sure all of us have evolved by this time where we can make out ki client वैसे ही पूछ रहा है अच्छा रेट में क्या कमी करोगे अच्छा बताओ ये कुछ टर्म्स वगैरह आपके फाइनल क्या है अच्छा कमर्शियल भेज दो but you are aware that this fellow is not into it and thereby बात बनने के चांस कम है. So I think very clear. Thank you Amresh for mentioning this. And therefore friends, one stage is this.
But sir, can I yeah, something yeah. I'm Tapan sir. But yeah, many please, times please. You know, doing business, say for example with your own sister concerns,
yeah,
where there is a lot of overlapping, becomes most difficult.
You cannot negotiate
with your known company associates.
Very right. And by the way, so many times there's no issue of negotiation also there.
Correct.
Because if the MD is the same, then he says chup chap le lo aur ye rate de do.
But I get a much better price outside, much better terms and contracts outside.
Absolutely. I understand what you are saying, which is a little exceptional situation where the buyer and the seller both are inside and the Malik is one. The promoter is one. And therefore, the promoter looks at his own income tax statement and thereby dictates ki ye wala price ko enter karo yahan pe. So great. Thank you, sir. Okay. So I am just showing you two slides. See, one is this. I would like to do business with you. Second is this. And thereby you need to make sure that the client very affirmatively says that I want to do business with you. कितना स्ट्रॉन्ग आप ये सिचुएशन कर सकते हैं वेयर ही सेज आई विल लाइक टू डू बिजनेस विद यू दैट इज व्हाट विल गिव यू एडवांटेज इन नेगोशिएशन. सेल सो वेल दैट योर नेगोशिएशन गिव्स यू बेटर रिजल्ट्स. एंड इफ यू विल अलाउ मी टू मेक अ लिटिल चेंज इन द स्टेटमेंट एंड से इट प्लीज टेल मी वेदर यू अंडरस्टैंड और नॉट. सेल सो वेल दैट योर नेगोशिएशन बिकम्स रिडंडेंट. Can someone identify with the statement I'm saying? Sell so well that your negotiation becomes redundant.
Correct. You create a pool. I mean, he then wants your material only.
Absolutely.
So he doesn't go for any much negotiation.
Absolutely. I remember very long back a situation where we did multiple visits to a client. I don't want to name the client here. It doesn't look nice. And when we were doing these multiple meetings with them, in some meetings their director was present, in some meetings there were L&D head was present, in some meeting even the MD was present. And when we had reached fifth, sixth meeting and there were final negotiations happening, the L&D manager, learning and development manager, said to us, he says, yaar apne rate theek kar lo kyunki humne kaam to aap hi se karwana hai. This is the statement he said. And I asked him, kaam hum hi se karwana hai, kisne bola? Kehta hai, hamare MD ne bola. Hamare MD ne humko bola, kaam to inhi se karwana hai, inko bolo, jara rate kam kar le, rate bada. What does the small conversation of 2 minute mean? What does the small conversation of 2 minutes mean?
It could be a tactics for getting the price lower also.
Okay, what else?
And of what course,
else? Someone else will say.
Yes, sir. I think the scope has been agreed. What the client wants and what you are offering has been agreed by both parties.
Okay.
And like my other sir said, they might also be looking to lower the prices more, you know.
Okay. Someone else will say, I hope I need not repeat it, but he said, काम तो आप ही से करवाना है, आप रेट ठीक कर लीजिए. मैंने पूछा किसने बोला हमसे करवाना, कहता है एमडी ने बोला ही नहीं से करवाना है. So, आप प्राइस ठीक कर लीजिए. Now, someone else will like to comment on this.
Right. It means that, this is Gajendra Benz. It means that now it is up to you to sweeten the deal for them. To say either, now I have, if they tell me, then I have a lot of play in my hand.
Yeah.
So they've given me the handle now.
Absolutely.
And now I have to change my position by which they get credit for getting sweetening the deal.
Either
I factor in that this is going to be my cost of increasing this negotiation further. So I don't have any cost now. If I do it now, I'm going to save. Or I throw in a little freebie. I say, okay, main iske saath aapko ye bhi ek aur de dunga.
Good one.
But at times it can also boomerang. If we come to know that possibly they are inclined towards us, you do not reduce price. You stick to your guns. It's also possible.
Yeah, absolutely. So we will take up the what is the major chance? That is what we will take up. Exceptions can always be there. So what I'm saying here is that now it is very clear that we have sold it very well to them. That is very clear. And when we have sold it very well to them, before we went into the meeting, we had decided in our mind that if worse comes to worse, we will come down by about 15%. That's what we had decided in our mind. And I was having a colleague also with me. And then when this statement came from the L&D manager, learning and development manager, we had some type of an eye-to-eye contact between my colleague and me. And decided that we are not going to give away more than 5% discount. Because the chances of taking the order, getting the order at 5% of discount is possible or not? The chances are very high because this guy has told that MD has said to them that kaam hi nahi se karwana. And therefore, whatever discount I am giving, maybe is to satisfy that person's ego. So that he should not feel ki yaar, tum to bade rigid ho. Tum to bilkul baat hi nahi karte ho. Tum to yaar, tum dekhte hi nahi ho kuch bhi. Maybe all those things may come in. And therefore, I need to give them some leeway so that a L&D head can also go to his MD or director and say, sir, I got 5% discount after a lot of negotiation with them. That is what he is going to say. And whereas we had that upper advantage because somehow the selling had gone well and because of which the negotiation was under our control. On the other side, if he would have said ki MD kehte hain mil lo aur inke siwaye aap 3-4 aur party ko bhi milna, mere ko na abhi ye samajh mein aaye nahi ye do. I have not been able to understand their position. I don't think they have understood our industry. If this is the statement our L&D head would have told us, maybe so as to grab the order, we would have gone into deeper negotiation. So friends, I hope this concept is clear. And therefore, I will not go too deep beyond this. If there are questions, I'll handle at the end. Okay. So now let me come to 5 principles of negotiation. I have discussed with you the relationship and difference between selling and negotiation. And the golden rule coming out is sell first, sell deep, before you enter into negotiation stage. Otherwise, avoid entering into negotiation stage till the time you have sold very well. Otherwise, I have seen many people, many salespeople, they go to a customer, they start telling about their own product, they have only told for 5-10 minutes. The customer says, haan, wo sab theek hai, mere ko maloom hai, aap rate batao apna. Aapne rate bata diya. ये तो बहुत ज्यादा, दिस इज टू हाई। चलो एनीवे आप मुझे अपना कमर्शियल टर्म वगैरह भेजिए, मैं आपको दो तीन दिन में बताता हूं। दिस इज व्हाट द कस्टमर सेड। नाउ दिस सेल्स पर्सन गोज बैक इन द ऑफिस टू हिज बॉस। बॉस सेज क्या हुआ, कहता सर बात बन जाएगी। क्यों बन जाएगी सर, कमर्शियल टर्म मांगा सर। He was already talking of negotiation, sir. And negotiation is a very advanced stage in a selling cycle. And if baat banegi, sir, mujhe lagta hai by month end we'll get this order. What do you feel based on this small verbal case study? What do you feel?
It's unlikely that you will get the order.
Absolutely unlikely, because you have not yet sold to him. You have still not convinced him about your services. Either he did not allow or you did not do is a separate matter. We cannot debate that here. But sachai ye hai, aap 5-10 minute hi baat kar paaye. After that, that fellow interjected and the client said, ki yaar aap rate batao aur baaki sab cheezein milwa do. And maybe the salesperson gave in too fast. Usko karna chahiye, nahi karna chahiye, kaise karna chahiye, wo baat ki baat hai. Wo ek apne aap mein topic hai. But what I'm trying to say here is, you felt that now that he is asking for the price, he has asked you for the commercial term, his order aa jayega, is foolish. And that is what happens every month. The salesperson counts this in his order book. Kehta sir ye order aa jana chahiye, pichle 4 mahine se dikha raha hai, pichle 4 mahine se wo boss ko dikha raha hai, sir is bar aa jayega. Sir maine unko baat bhi kiya tha, maine follow up bhi kiya tha, and that fellow says ha ha main kuch karta hu, sir aa jayega. 4 mahine se nahi aaya. And this fellow doesn't even know ki kyun nahi aa raha hai. So friends, these are the things about selling and negotiation. Let me come to 5 principles of negotiation. This is what one should keep in mind. And as I was saying, khud ka pata nahi chalta hai. Isliye if you will have a colleague who can observe you while negotiating, he will be able to tell you whether you are following these or not. First is this. Try getting their whole agenda, the other party's whole agenda. Whether you are a buyer or a seller, try to know figures within each. Generally, the sad part is mostly negotiation for most of the people only mean price. Sabse bada blunder hi hui hai. I need to understand what all does the customer have in mind. And whole agenda means what are their payment terms? How much material they require? What is the delivery schedule? Where do they want it? When do they want it? Are there some quality control issues? Many of these things. And I don't even ask. As a seller, if I don't ask, to main mar jaunga. As a buyer, he does not ask, to alag baat hai. Because generally, buyer ke paas kaafi alternatives hote hain. But as a seller, main nahi puch raha hu, it's foolish. But mere ko lagta hai, price hi to hai. And therefore, you need to know about everything. So, jab price ki baat hui, so then a smart negotiator will say, what else beyond price? When do you want it? Generally, what are your price terms or what are your payment terms? Do you have some quality checks? Will you accept this? Will this happen? Will that happen? He will ask many things and thereby suddenly discovers at the end of 10 minutes or 15 minutes that there are 7 parameters instead of only one. And within those 7 parameters, if I could know figures on most of those, I may not know on all. He says a quality check ka bataya, sir, aapne jara bataiye isme kya hai? कहता हाँ बॉस, वी हैव दिस नॉर्म विद इन दिस 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 वी एक्सेप्ट, अदरवाइज वी डोंट एक्सेप्ट, और वी एक्सेप्ट विद अ पेनल्टी। सो देन यू नो द फिगर्स, नो यू नीड टू नो द फिगर्स विद इन ईच, यू नीड टू ट्राई। मे बी कईयों का मिलेगा, कईयों का नहीं मिलेगा। देयर इज सम बैकग्राउंड नॉइज,
तो मैं ही तुम्हारा बाप।
सम बैकग्राउंड नॉइज।
वी रिक्वेस्ट पीपल हु आर पार्टिसिपेटिंग काइंडली कीप योर माइक्रोफोन्स ऑन म्यूट।
आई थिंक मिस्टर इकबाल कैन म्यूट देम from the participant menu.
Yeah, I'm aware. Thank you. If you have, okay, the second principle is, you may want to write it down or after I show all, you may like to take a screenshot. If you have to open, never initiate with most contentious issue. The contention means very debatable, very hot. You have to initiate. You have to say, अच्छा आपका क्या है? आप बताइए. And mostly it starts with price. Again, that's a blunder. If you are very keen about getting an order, getting an agreement, please don't start with the negotiation of price. So when the customer says, aap bataiye final price kya lagega? A smart negotiator will say, sir, haan main idea deta hu, aapko delivery kab tak chahiye? Acha, delivery aapko parts mein chalegi kya? Or you all want in one go only?
Okay, okay. And you want it where? You want it at your factory? Oh, factory is in Odisha. My God, oh, I didn't know this. So, आप कह रहे हो उड़ीसा वाले फैक्ट्री पे चाहिए. अच्छा अच्छा. ऐसे जनरली पेमेंट टर्म्स क्या होती हैं आपकी? So you have initiated on some other issues which are not so contentious. Instead of landing into a head-to-head collision, head-to-head collision means he's talking of price, you are talking of price, which is the most crucial issue for both of them. And वो कहता नहीं बॉस मैं तो इतने से ज़्यादा नहीं हूँ. और आप कहते हो सॉरी सर मेरे पास तो परमिशन ही नहीं है इससे ज़्यादा की. And finally, the negotiation breaks down.
Instant pot में.
And generally, आजकल क्या है buyer India का भी Japanese type हो गया है. They don't say no. They say अच्छा ठीक है बॉस मैं बाद में बताता हूँ. I will let you know. और ठीक देखा जाए उसने कह दिया भैया आपसे बात नहीं बनेगी. अब आप 5 दिन बाद दोबारा फोन करते हैं कहता वो तो डील हो गई बॉस किसी को अगली बार देखेंगे आपके साथ. सो फ्रेंड्स आई होप यू हैव गॉट इट. बी हाई बट बी क्रेडिबल व्हाइल कोटिंग द टर्म्स पर्टिकुलरली द प्राइस. आई हैव सीन सम पीपल हु गेट वेरी एंबिशियस व्हाइल कोटिंग एंड लेट्स से यू हैव कोटेड 100 एंड यू हैव बिकम वेरी एंबिशियस एंड फाइनली you are coming down to 50. My God. You will lose credibility, no? Aapne 100 bola aur finally 50 pe aa gaye. You will lose credibility. And by the way, I'm sure you, many of you would have gone to some of these busy markets everywhere, which are tourist markets. And in Delhi at least, Connaught Place and Karol Bagh are known for that. And there are many people who are selling belts or selling goggles. And he's after you, sir, le lo, bahut badhiya hai, ye le lo. Aapne pucha kitne ka, sir, 500 ka. And when you don't show your interest, you start walking, the fellow will come down finally to 100 rupees. He loses his credibility. And therefore, you need to have this internal discussion that if our cutoff is 50, our cutoff is 50, what is the highest I want to quote? That decision has to be done. I'm no one to define that. But you say cutoff is 50, we will quote 100. There's too much of a difference. Maybe you people will say, nahin yaar, in that case, we will quote 70. Because 70 se 50 yana credible hai, 100 se 50 yana credible nahin. So this is what it means. And therefore, be credible even when you're quoting higher. Okay, the next one. Keep even small giveaways for trading. Don't just agree to give otherwise. Just like that. So which means often the other party in between says ki boss nahi delivery to hume chahiye by 30th October yaar aap kya baat kar rahe ho 15 November se pehle nahi aa sakti baat hi banegi and suddenly I say acha chalo sir 30 October tak karwa dunga I have written down main 30 October tak karwa dunga sir because you know piche that ho jayegi 30 October tak ke I'll put up this you know that and now you come to price or whatever else but I'm saying price because price is the most critical factor. And now you start discussing price. Have you already given your one advantage of delivery before 30th October without fighting for it? Have you done or not? Amresh, what do you feel? Already delivery ka advantage given away or not?
Sir, you are breaking. Could you please repeat the question?
Yeah. What I'm saying is, the client said ki yaar delivery mujhe 30th October tak I want. And you had quoted 15th November. When he was insisting on 30th October, you said, okay, granted, sir, I will arrange by 30th October, no worry.
Yes, sir.
And now the negotiation goes on price.
Yes.
Tell me what wrong has happened or what is your comment on this?
Sir, may I say something?
Yeah.
Sir, actually, in legal terms, there is a breach of contract. Mm-hmm. And in this case, the seller might be he may be negotiating in terms of price because he is unable to deliver the products at the desired day.
I don't know. Please don't mind. You have not got it. Breach of contract ko ho nahi sakta. The contract is still not signed. The contract is being discussed. The negotiation is happening. No.
Achha.
So when sir, negotiation is happening. The client wanted by 30th October, you had quoted 15th November. You agreed on 30th October. Now you are discussing the price.
Yes.
Sir. Now I'm telling you what your reaction on this.
Sir, can I answer this, sir?
Yeah.
Sir, I think there is a very good important thing of credibility in this because Since you had you had said you'd be delivering by November 15, and now you are agreeing to the client's terms, the client might be a little bit suspicious, you know, whether you can deliver it or not, because you had quoted, so they might not like that.
Okay. So let me say it. Huh? Please allow me to say it so as to go faster, please. Huh? Otherwise, I would have given this opportunity to many people. So credibility as a principle, we have already covered. Here, what I'm saying is, when you knew that you can give it by 30th October, should you agree upfront or should you keep it with you so as to trade against something else? You are agreeing upfront. Okay, sir, I will arrange by 30th October. Why? Instead of that, you say, okay, sir, I have written it. Let me see if we can help you. I don't know as of now. I'm writing it down. Which means you have not given away. You have not given away this big advantage that you can supply by 30th October. You have kept it by saying, sir, let me look at it. I don't know. So you have kept it. And later on, when there's a discussion happening on price, there's a discussion happening on payment terms, that time you can bring it out, no? And then while you bring it out, that time you can say, boss, if you want it by 30th October, then we will need to have at least 50% payment in the beginning. If you want it by 30th of October, then we cannot go on price below this. Because we have a constraint, because there are so many other customers we have to supply it to. Which means you have not given away that term. Instead of that, you have kept it with you so that you can trade it against something later on. I hope this is clear. Not otherwise, really. I'll come back to your questions later on. Please don't mind. I hope many people would have got it. So please allow me to go to the next one. Be credible while giving concession. This is a little different from the third one. Let me quickly go into a slide and try to give you an example. There are not many slides I had, and I have shortlisted some of those. So let me quickly see if I can come to that slide and show you. Yeah. Everyone have a look at this, please. Which one is better, A or B?
Definitely B is more credible.
Okay. Someone else shows
that
say?
You have shared the maximum discount and now it is not possible. Further.
Excellent. So he has given a good discount in the beginning, but he was pressurized further. The next figure was smaller. When further you felt that I may lose the order, then the last figure is very small. Whereas AMA, you will lose your credibility. Because in the beginning, you gave 3%, then you gave 5%, then you gave 7%. Yeah. Though the total discount in the A is what? 15%. In the B1, total discount is how much?
17%.
Even then B is better. I hope this is clear, whatever this gentleman explained just now. And therefore, please don't increase your concessions. Don't increase your discounts later on pressure. You will lose your credibility. So I'll go back now. And therefore, we have covered these five principles. I have taken some examples. And now, after this, let me go to what is BATNA, ZOPA and VAP. BATNA, let me first go to BATNA and explain you a little and then quickly do it. And after that, we need to have some time for question answer. BATNA means best alternative to a negotiated agreement. It's a very famous acronym, generally used at very senior level negotiations, which means that before you enter into a very crucial meeting, you and your boss are going and your boss says कि क्या लगता है अगर ये ऑर्डर नहीं आया तो, और आपने कहा सर क्या बात कर रहे हो सर, मर जाऊंगा सर ये ऑर्डर नहीं आया तो, क्यों? कहता सर मेरा टारगेट पूरा नहीं होगा, आगे मेरा 2-3 महीने से टारगेट पूरा नहीं हो रहा है, आई विल बी इन अ वेरी टफ सिचुएशन एंड बाय द वे आई विल ऑल्सो नॉट अर्न माय इंसेंटिव सर, बड़ा जरूरी है, विच मीन्स यू हैव अ पुअर ऑल्टरनेटिव टू दिस एग्रीमेंट, यू डोंट हैव एन ऑल्टरनेटिव एंड बिकॉज ऑफ विच यू आर अंडर टू मच ऑफ अ प्रेशर टू क्लोज इट. You are under too much of a pressure to close it. And because you are under too much of a pressure, you may give away certain things because you want to close it. What will you go to in case this negotiation breaks down? What are the alternatives you have? And it helps in preventing failure of negotiation either by giving too many concessions. You are giving too many concessions because you are dependent on this law. You don't want to lose it at all. बिल्कुल छोड़ दिया करता था, जैसा आप बोलोगे वैसा करेंगे, और यू फील कि यार नहीं मेरे पास बहुत अल्टरनेटिव है, डोंट वरी, देन इन दैट केस यू होल्ड फॉर टू लॉन्ग, यू डोंट गिव अवे, नहीं सर बॉस इससे कम नहीं कर पाएंगे, नहीं तो रहने दीजिए सर कोई बात नहीं, विच मीन्स यू मे देन लूज दैट एग्रीमेंट बिकॉज यू फेल्ट दैट आई हैव टू मेनी अल्टरनेटिव्स टू इट, देयरफॉर यू नीड टू थिंक बिफोर हैंड क्या मेरे पास काफी और अल्टरनेटिव्स हैं. चाइना एंड इंडिया, whatever tough time they are having on the border, I'm very sure both sides are looking at what is the best alternative to if the situation breaks down. And I'm sure Indian government has also seen if the situation breaks down, we will go to war. And we will go to war. And in that case, I'm sure whatever we know, India is very well prepared in Ladakh now, very well prepared. I'm very sure that Indian army would have also prepared for Arunachal also by the way. Because they know that China will then maybe attack from there. That is also our land. And if India is well prepared at both these places, then the army general says to the defense minister, boss, I'm totally prepared, absolutely no issues. If your negotiations break down, no issues. So I'm just taking an example which just came to my mind out of this. Now let me come to Zopa and VAP. By that, we will wrap the session and after that over to Sandeep and Goel sir. So Zopa is zone of possible agreement. In the center, if you see the green one, zone of possible agreement, which means you as a seller are going with certain range. Maine 100 quote kiya hai, main 70 tak aa sakta hoon. And buyer also has some range ki main 50 se shuru karunga, parantu agar mujhe 75 pe bhi lena pada to main le lunga. Which means the zone of possible agreement is between 70 and 75. Mera low is 70 hai, uska high is 75 hai, man mein hai. Bataya kisi ko nahi hai. And the same for other conditions, payment terms, delivery terms, quality terms. To sab ke upar there is some range both parties have. And then within those range, what is the possible agreement zone? That is what is Zopa. And therefore, a smart negotiator will predict this in the beginning. He will predict. The other party will not tell him upfront, but he will predict. And VAP is walk away price. Walk away price, something similar to Patna, where he says, boss, iske niche nahi jaunga as a seller. Or the buyer says, isse jyada bilkul nahi dunga. Come what may, I cannot give more than 75 because his MD told, ki yaar 75 se hi jyada dena hai, tumhara existing supplier bura hai kya? We will be with him, don't worry yaar. We will not give more than 75 at all. And similarly, on the other side, whatever they have thought of. And now the challenge is during negotiation, how do you make the other party extend this zone? Wo soch ke aaye the 75 de denge. A good smart seller has been able to bring their limit to 80. And a good buyer maybe has been able to bring him down from 70 to 65. This depends who is the better smart negotiator. And at the end of it, अगर ये एग्रीमेंट चलनी है, इट हैज टू बी एग्जीक्यूटेड ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम, ओवर 1 year, ओवर 2 years, ओवर 5 years, देन बोथ पार्टीज नीड टू बी ट्रस्टवर्दी. दैट इज व्हाट इज विन विन, व्हिच गोयल सर वाज सेइंग इन द बिगनिंग, दैट यू नीड टू थिंक ऑफ विन विन, बिकॉज मोस्ट ऑफ द नेगोशिएशंस यू नीड टू हैव अ लॉन्ग टर्म रिलेशनशिप एंड बिकॉज ऑफ व्हिच यू वांट टू बी कम अक्रॉस एज अ ट्रस्टवर्दी गाय, अ गाय हु विल ऑनर द टर्म्स एंड कंडीशंस व्हिच हैव बीन एग्रीड. This is what it means by win-win. But if you are selling your old car, which you will say and say goodbye to that person, तो विन विन की क्या चिंता है, कहता भैया पैसे आ जाए गाड़ी ले जाओ, तो आपको देखना है बाद में गाड़ी कैसी है, यही चेक कर लो जैसा है, प्लीज डोंट टेल मी आफ्टर टू डेज किस में तो इंजन में प्रॉब्लम है, ये प्रॉब्लम है, बस अभी देख लो, इन दैट केस देयर इज नो इशू ऑफ विन विन बिकॉज इट्स अ वन टाइम डील. सो फ्रेंड्स दिस इज व्हाट आई प्रॉमिस यू दैट आई विल कवर दीज थ्री थिंग्स, रिलेशनशिप एंड डिफरेंस बिटवीन सेलिंग एंड नेगोशिएशन वी हैव डन, देन फाइव मंत्रास, फाइव प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ गुड इफेक्टिव नेगोशिएशन आई हैव डन, एंड आई टोल्ड यू आई विल टेल यू अबाउट बाटना जूपा एंड वैप व्हिच आई हैव डन. ओवर टू यू संदीप.
Thank you, Mr. Anna. Mr. Anna, I request you to transfer. Achha, Mr. Goyal is now the host. Great, it was exciting. And in fact, you covered the three critical aspects of negotiation, which are very, very important. And I think in a very, very simple way, you shared a lot of information with simple examples. That was great. And at this stage, we haven't got any many questions right now yet. So what we can do is, on negotiation, I'm sure each of us have had our own share of experiences which are there. And with this, I'm sure Mr. Goyal, you must have gone through various negotiations in business transactions also, with your teams also handling them.
Yeah, and Sandeep, after Mr. Goyal shares something interesting,
yes,
if you will want me, then I had searched out in YouTube a small clipping of Diwar movie where is a negotiation happening between Amitabh Bachchan and a person who is a seller. So if you will like me to show that, I will show that, which is a 2-minute clip of Diwar movie. But before that, over to Goyal sir.
Thank you. You see, when I was into like vocational skilling, so we had a setup of around 680 plus centers across India. Mm-hmm. Foremost thing, what I used to feel when a franchisee partner used to come to take the franchisee of our brand, they had multiple things in their mind. Like they have gone to met different brands, they had their franchisee fees, royalties, services, many, many things they used to have their own checklist agenda. So I remember that one of the negotiation lasted up to 5 hours, where the person was kept on talking about price, but behind every price negotiation, he used to come up with one more point. So actually I could understand from the discussion that he's not talking about the price mainly, he has certain more queries. So as a negotiator, if you're selling your product and if you don't understand where the customer is getting into, and you start negotiating on the price, probably you lose the deal in the beginning itself.
Right.
The price negotiation has to happen in the last. And first you must understand the customer, what he's looking at, what is his pain points, what actually he's going to buy, your services, your brand, your price. So once it is dealt with, probably negotiation will happen very smoothly, I think.
Right.
Good it's one, about trading of concessions, which Mr. Rana, you pointed out. Because those are very, very critical.
But I think what Goyal Saab is saying, yes, that you need to be very observant.
Very observant.
You need to be very good listener and try to understand iske, iski statement ke piche hai kya. That is what he is saying. Excellent.
I agree. It's very, very well preparation which is there. Because my experiences of negotiations are mostly to collaborations, which takes place around 2 days or 3 days for negotiation. So without the basic planning, things cannot happen. And it is a huge trading of concessions that is there.
Sandeep,
do we have any questions from any of our participants, any of our viewers?
I'm sorry to interrupt. He plays his clip, can we invite Dr. K.K. Upadhyay, like Iqbalji?
Yes.
Sure.
So can we have 2 minutes?
Yes, Dr. Upadhyay is a very learned man.
So nice, very nice to be with you. I think these are the type of things which we all need. And I found Iqbal, I am seeing him for the first time. You are excellent, the way you talk and all. So I am coming here for learning, basically.
Learn from you, sir.
Thank you so much.
No, we want to learn.
Mr. Goyal, any comments?
You see, first, as I said earlier, one must understand the customer he's dealing with.
Right.
So you have an X-ray or MRI or CT scan of the customer, then it comes in a better position, how to deal with
it. Yeah.
Kind of goof up will not happen.
True. True.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Question with the, from Varun Khilani, I think, in the chat box. So, can you read that, Sandeep, from the chat box?
Varun
Tilwani.
Yeah. There is a question which Varun Tilwani has mentioned. I'm reading it out. Sir, generally in India, there is a basic attitude from the seller side that even if we try to negotiate, they usually say, if you want to, but please move forward. Otherwise, I have other customers to buy the same product or services. This is a statement, I think.
One more question is asked. I want to ask a question that why women are more efficient in negotiation skills?
Right, this was the first question which he has asked.
Yeah. Gentlemen, this is Gajendra Bain speaking. I just have a request. I have to jump off to another meeting at 4.
Yeah, welcome, sir.
Yeah, so this is just an observation. I think it's very important what Mr. Rana said in the beginning about knowing, having a coach for you for negotiation. And right. It's very important to understand one's negotiation style because there are many negotiation styles and it is impossible for a person to have all. But if one understands one's own negotiation style, then one knows how to use that very effectively. And I have found realization was I went to a negotiation training meeting. I was from purchase side and other people were from sales side. And initially I was the outlier and I kind of thought that I'm a very poor negotiator till someone explained to me that that is my negotiation style. If I understand that, that is equally, if not more powerful. So in negotiation, sometimes it helps to have a team and it always helps to have a coach. In fact, pairs where one person does the talking and the other person does the observation. And when a person does the summing up of the meeting, the other person helps him understand what was his reaction and what was the other side's reaction. That's very important. Thank you very much.
Excellent. Excellent, sir. Excellent. Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
I'll just add to what Mr. Indra said.
Thank you.
The Japanese have one person in the meeting who is actually controlling the negotiation temperament, but you will find him not speaking a word in the whole meeting.
Yeah.
Putting the feedbacks to everybody. And they divide their questions. Every person has their own set of questions. And the person who is handling that entire negotiation, he'll keep mum.
True. True. Very
excellent.
True. Very true. Mr. Rana, you would like to answer the question of Varun Tilwani?
This is a very regarding women wala?
Yeah.
this is a very tough one. We need to have a lady to answer it.
Right. So that is, I feel there is no specific reason. It's about, I think, more about planning and taking it on, right? Okay, if anybody has any queries, they can always write to us. And with this, I think we have come to the end of the session for today. Thanks everybody. Thanks for joining in. And it was wonderful interacting with you all. Thank you, Mr. Rana. For your
thank
time.
You.
Thank you, Mr. Goyal.
And
thank you, everybody.
And Sandeep.
Thank you very much.
Sandeep.
Yes.
Just to inform everyone that on YouTube, if they will write corporate productivity consulting,
sure.
Our channel will appear, which has two small 5-minute clippings on negotiation.
Sure.
Right.
Okay. Thank you, everybody.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Thank you, Goyal sir.
Thank you.
Well, thank you, Sandeep.
Thank you.
Bye. Bye-bye.